Up until now, we've talked about OSS and BSS as a collective term. But you might well be wondering, where does OSS end and where does BSS begin? Is there a clear demarcation? It's a common question that's asked. Now, to my knowledge, there is no official answer to these questions. TM Forum and the other bodies have never attempted to map OSS versus BSS. It sets off too many religious wars. At a risk of setting off some religious wars of my own, here's my attempt at mapping OSS versus BSS onto the TAM that we described earlier. We know that from a high-level perspective, an OSS supports the network and operations teams, which are usually back of house, so resource allocation, service activation, and assurance on the chart shown. Meanwhile, BSS supports the customer-facing teams, or front of house, like sales and marketing, product, customer orders, and billing. But you'll also notice that these tools tend to overlap at the service domain layer, which is why they're shaded in grey. For what it's worth, I come from an era when my OSS tools had a lot of functionality that could arguably be classified as BSS-centric. Product management, customer relationship management, service order entry, and more. They also happen to deliver functionality that others might classify as network management systems or element management systems via their nature. And we'll talk a bit more about those shortly. But in my mind, they've always just been software that supports operationalization of the network. It's one of the reasons why I call my site Passionate About OSS, not Passionate About OSS, BSS, NMS, EMS. Now, what are EMS and NMS? Well, we'll cover that next.